One big reason not to add any new states to the 50 we've got is that I memorized that 50 state song way back in second grade. Alabama, etc. And I'm not going to relearn it. Don't like your neighbors? Tired of fighting with them about politics? Just move out of the state. Or actually, even better, just make a new state. A new state like, say, Greater Idaho. What is Greater Idaho, you ask? Well, it's not technically a state yet, but it would be Idaho plus a bunch of conservative counties in eastern Oregon that are sick of being represented by Democrats at every level of government. Quote, Oregon is largely controlled by one party that does not represent the entire state effectively, making the urban and rural divide striking. That's State Senator Herman Bartscheiger, the Republican leader in the state Senate, who represents Josephine County, in an email to CNN. And he's at least partly right. Oregon's governor, both U.S. senators, and four of its five House members are all Democrats. The Democratic presidential nominee has won the state 8 straight times. And as the Almanac of American Politics, which is a wonderful book, great stocking stuffer, notes, the state has voted more Democratic than the country as a whole in each of the last 4 presidential elections. 2016, the last presidential election, Hillary Clinton won the state by 11 points after losing the state's Democratic presidential primary to liberal Vermont Senator Bernie Sanders. Now, just because Oregon is quite Democratic doesn't mean there aren't conservatives within the state's lines. There are, but many of them live in eastern Oregon on the other side of the Cascades, far away from Portland and the population centers. Which brings me to a group called Move Oregon's Border for a Greater Idaho, which is organizing a series of county-level initiatives aimed to be on the ballot in 2020 that would allow eastern Oregon counties to leave the state and join, as the group's name suggests, a new and bigger Idaho. Greater Idaho. Quote, Democrats should be paying attention to how unhappy these Oregonians are with the current regime to seek secession from Oregon, Bartscheiger said in a statement. He added, I would welcome the idea to serve on the Greater Idaho legislature, end quote, sidebar. There is no Greater Idaho, just to be clear, end sidebar. Now, let's get one other thing very clear before we go on. This is not going to happen. To change the boundaries of a state, the state legislatures of both states, the old one and the new one, would have to approve, as would a majority of Congress. It's right there in the Constitution. Great document. In fact, besides minor tweaks, it's been more than 100 years since U.S. boundaries have changed or expanded in any meaningful way. And it'd be hard to see the Oregon legislature, which is controlled by Democrats, willingly hand over counties and representation to its conservative neighbor to the east. But the Greater Idaho effort is far from the only attempt by residents of one state to become residents of another state due solely to political affiliation. In West Virginia, for example, there's an ongoing attempt in the state legislature to add several northwestern Virginia counties to the Mountain State, a move known colloquially as VEXIT. Sidebar, whether or not you support said move, VEXIT is an amazing name. Now, the motivation for VEXIT backers is much the same as what's behind the Greater Idaho movement. Virginia has moved to the left as the state's population in the DC suburbs has continued to soar. Voters in parts of the state far removed from Washington, DC are significantly more conservative and don't feel as though their views are being properly represented, hence VEXIT. Quote, if you're not truly happy where you are, we stand with open arms to take you from Virginia or anywhere you may be. West Virginia Republican Governor Jim Justice said in early 2020, and he added this, we stand strongly behind the Second Amendment and we stand strongly for the unborn, end quote. Liberty University President Jerry Falwell Jr. is also an outspoken advocate for VEXIT. Liberty is in Virginia. Now, the two states, Virginia and West Virginia, were, of course, once one state. Following Virginia's vote to secede from the Union in the run-up to the Civil War, West Virginians broke off, opposing that move. West Virginia was then recognized as a state by President Abraham Lincoln in 1863. Now, while these latest movements will almost certainly not secede, they speak to a broader truth about our current political culture. There's an increasing desire to only live around, work around, and be around people who share the same political beliefs that you do. In a 2017 Pew poll, 2/3 of self-identified Democrats said they had only a few or no friends that were Republicans. A slightly smaller 55%, still a majority, of Republicans said they had few or no Democratic friends. None. And we've seen recent presidential elections that blue Democratic areas are getting bluer and red Republican areas are getting redder. Heck, we don't even watch the same shows or get our news from anything like the same places anymore. So is it any wonder that people now want to live in other states that are more aligned with their politics? Look, movements like VEXIT and the Greater Idaho effort aren't going to come to fruition. But the fact that they exist at all tell us a great deal about the depressing future of our body politic. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday, Thursday, and now a special week in review episode every weekend. Make sure to check them all out.